Welcome back to the explanation of the paperboy use case. This time, part four. And so far, we have focused on modeling and analysis of the impact of the as-is situation of the business model to the plan of the paperboy. And this time, we will show you how we can make a transformation from as-is to the to-be situation. Because, as you can remember, in the as-is situation, he delivered a poor service to the readers of the newspaper due to his own low availability. As you can see here, there is the first phase, called poor service. This represents the as-is situation. And he has a low availability because he was just not showing up. And then the newspapers, the readers didn't get a newspaper or didn't get it very late. And they were very dissatisfied with him. And therefore, he thought about an improvement and to make a transformation from bad, poor service to a to-be phase, and we call it here a better service, based on an arrangement of a backup network of schoolmates. So he found schoolmates and the school class interested in helping him and to be a stand-in for him when he himself would not be available. And of course, these schoolmates also want to earn something. They need a compensation for that. And that means that the paperboy himself will earn less, has less profit. But he accepts that because everything is better than losing his paper route. Because based on the new situation, though he earns a little bit less, there is basically no risk anymore of losing his paper route. So we will show you now how you can model that and analyze that in the VDMB value management platform. But before we go into it, just remember this network, this participant network or value network, which is underlying the business model. This was the network in the first phase that you have seen already. And now we extend the model by adding another network. We call it here a backup network. And the participants there are again the paperboy, we call it here in the role of proxy, and his schoolmates in the role of stand-in. So these schoolmates in the role of stand-in will deliver a value proposition that we call here backup to him. And the paperboy in this role of proxy provides delivery work to these schoolmates in the role of stand-in. Okay, now into the app. As you can see here, the plan of the paperboy, you see the same two phases here. So far we have analyzed in a lot of detail this as a situation, poor service. Now we go into the second phase, the to-be phase, better service. The business model is still the same business model here, although it's transformed here, as you will see. Go into it. And let's look into participants. So the newspaper network was already there. Now we added a network called the backup network. You know, it's the schoolboy in his role of proxy, and he deals with schoolmates in the role of stand-in, and these act as partner just to the schoolboy. Okay, go up. Based on that, additional value propositions. So for instance, delivery work. Go up. Who? The schoolboy, in his role of proxy, offers what? So actually the value proposition. Delivery work to the schoolmates in the role of stand-in. And as you can see, the value that goes with that, important for his schoolmates, is the compensation. A compensation of €5 per round. Okay? If you click a pencil, for instance. So you see this compensation, can you go down? This compensation is aggregated up to backup cost. See, backup cost, you know, which is part of the proposition to the paperboy. Backup cost itself is, you know, the frequency of delivery times this compensation. Here you can see the impact of it, this compensation, times the net backup availability. We come to that in a minute. Okay, go down. And if you aggregate even further up to total cost, you see, up, you see that in the as-is situation, we had only a cost of extra byte cost. But here there is a total cost, which is the combination of backup cost, because there's additional, and the extra buy cost go down. And if you go even further up to profit in the plan, you know, and that didn't change, but the impact is there, of course, because total revenue minus total cost. If total cost is 4, total revenue is lower, profit will be lower. Yeah? Right? Close this one. Close this one. Yeah, close all these. And now go back to the value propositions. There is one more new value proposition. So backup. That's the other way around. So the schoolmates, in return, in the role of stand-in, offers as a value proposition backup to the schoolboy in the role of proxy. And what value comes with that? So what's important for this schoolboy in the role of proxy? What would he like to get to himself? Of course, availability, because his own availability is very low. So their availability should be very high. You can see it, there's 99% here, but okay. If you click on that one, you can see that this has an impact to the net backup availability. That also influences the cost, remember? And when you go further up, this is determined. The net backup availability is determined as follows. It's 100% minus paperboy availability. So basically when the paperboy himself is not available, times the availability of the schoolmates as a percentage, divided by 100%. So here you can calculate, come down. And this is aggregated further up to net availability, and there's further influence as well as backup cost. But you believe that. Close this one. Let's close this one. Okay. Close. Yeah, close. Okay. So you can also go it in other ways. For instance, to the proposition, the value that the schoolboy himself captures. For instance, to the cost proposition. You see that there is more values here. Close a little bit. So there's a cost proposition to himself. There is a backup cost, as you have seen, a total cost. Click on this one. It's the same value as you've seen earlier. Backup cost plus extra buy cost. Close this one. Yeah. Let's now look to the right-hand side for a moment, where we visualize some of this impact. You know, can you come down a little bit? Yeah. Okay. Basically, we have selected three values for you, all at the business model level. So one is the promptness. You see that promptness goes up. That's logical, because there is better availability now. As a consequence of that, the receiver satisfaction goes up a lot. Yeah, we will show you in a minute where that comes from. Okay. And as a consequence of that, the risk of loss of paper round goes down dramatically, basically from a very high risk to almost to no risk anymore. So that's very good. So that is what happens here. Before we go up to the plan to see what the result is at the plan level, just go into that promptness for a while. So remember, the newspaper receivers will experience better promptness now. So due to which they are more satisfied. And you could go up a little bit. All right, value, no, go up a little bit. Go to value propositions. And we go to a value proposition that they had already, namely newspaper on the mat. That was already the first phase. Go up. There was already a promptness, but it's higher now. It's higher now, higher promptness. And based on promptness, we measure the satisfaction of the subscribers, of the receivers of the newspaper. And you see that the satisfaction is now 100%. That is because it's become now in a higher interval. Because as soon as the availability, the total availability, comes above 95%, the satisfaction will be 100%. Okay, close this one. Close this one. And you can see it here, satisfaction 100%. Okay. But let's now go up to my propositions, so the value that the schoolboy himself captures. And we look to the risk proposition. Risk proposition. Go up. Risk of loss of paper route. That was already calculated in the first place, but now you see the impact after all these changes. We calculate as 100 minus the receiver satisfaction. So if the receiver satisfaction is very low, as it was, you know, then you have a high risk. But if the receiver satisfaction now itself becomes 100%, you have no risk anymore. This one becomes zero. Close this one. So that explains what you see over here. Now, but there is also impact further up at plan level. OK? Okay, so go to plan level. Yep. Here you see similar graph, but now for values at the plan level, based on which you want to steer, seeing whether his plan transformation is successful or not. You see that hourly income goes down a bit, and profit goes down a bit. That is because of that compensation for the other guys, the schoolmates. But due to this, the revenue at risk just drops down to zero, as we explained already. So this is what the paperboy found. And he decided based on this that he will go for this. Okay. If not, let's say if it would have happened that this is not really satisfactory to him, he would have laid down himself thinking more, could we improve in otherwise? And then he would, for instance, just shortly, go to my plans, go into this, click this one, create another alternative, plus for instance. And either by cloning an existing one or whatever, he creates another alternative, does the similar analysis there, maybe by different changes of the business model, and see how the impact at the plan level goes there. But that's enough for now, maybe. Till next time.